Stephen.
Hello, Stephen.
Good morning. Good morning. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Good morning to you.
We're very good.
And,
thank
and
you.
And where are you?
We're in London.
Oh, you're in London. Oh, I'm in New York.
No, no, no. We're going back. No, not New York.
How's the weather there? Has it warmed up any?
A little bit. Yeah, it's been quite cold.
Yes.
So I've spoken to Steve and I've spoken to Jeff Pope, so I'm talking to everybody from Philomena, including the real Philomena, which is you.
The real Philomena.
Yes. So, Philomena, you just had an audience with the Pope?
Me? I did.
Yes. What was that like? Tell our viewers. How exciting. What an incredible moment.
Incredible. Me, I've just had an audience with the Pope. So incredible. What an honor it was for me to meet the Pope. I just couldn't believe from where I was all them years ago as an unmarried mother to meeting the Pope. I just could not believe it. It's a wonderful experience. And what can I say? It was a charming, lovely gentleman.
Were you inside? Were you outside? Where did this happen in Rome?
We were actually in St. Peter's Square. We went to the, they have a mass every Wednesday morning, and we went to that. So we sat at the mass, and then we met the Pope afterwards. And then later on in the afternoon, we watched the film in the Vatican with two of the Pope's aides. The Pope didn't see it with us, but his aides did.
What an incredible, incredible honor. Wow. Yeah. Considering what happened, either of you, if you want to just tell our viewers quickly, what was the story that led up to this, in case they haven't seen the film yet? Mm-hmm. And everybody should see it.
Mm. Did she talk? Mum had a secret for 50 years. She told me 10 years ago that she'd had a baby in Ireland in the 1950s. And as soon as she told me, I wanted to go all out to try and find him. And from that, I discovered that I'm brought up in the United Kingdom, so we have open adoption records. When you're 18, you can go and trace if you want to. But from Mum telling me the story, I learned that that's not the same everywhere. I know there's some states in the United States where they're closed adoption records, and it's the same in Ireland. So we've kind of been on this incredible journey ever since.
Yeah.
Met the journalist Martin Sixsmith, who a mutual friend of mine knew, and he helped us discover this incredible story that's brought us to where we are now.
And in the movie, it's been and you've been nominated for all these Oscars. Steve has been nominated, and he just won the BAFTA. Were you at the BAFTAs?
We were. Yes, we were.
Yeah. What was that like?
Yeah. Wasn't that wonderful? I'm so pleased for Jeff. For Steve and Jeff, you know, I was really, really pleased for them.
It was very, very exciting that they won one. And you can imagine we were all incredibly pleased.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wow. Yeah, because really we don't get to see it on the air here. It's not aired here, but you can sort of see bits of it on YouTube and stuff.
Yeah.
Are you going to the, and it's also, you're also nominated for Oscars. Are you going to the Oscars?
Oh, yes. Huh? We've been invited, yes. Yeah.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, wonderful.
I know. That will be tremendous. What an amazing experience for both of us.
Oh, so you're both going. How fabulous. And quickly, Philomena, if you want to talk a little about meeting Dame Judi Dench. Wow.
Wow. Wow. All I can say is, wow, what a wonderful lady. When I first discovered that she was going to play my part, well, I couldn't believe it. I just could not believe it at first because, I mean, not knowing, I've watched her all every film she's ever been in. She's done some lovely afternoon programs that I've always watched at home. But when Steve had asked her if she would take the part on, and she agreed, and then when he told me, I thought, my goodness, Steve Coogan, Jeff, oh my God, I could not believe it. But it was so exciting. And of course, none of my friends would believe it because I thought I was going a little bit, I don't know what they thought they were. That's all I can say. They really did. They said, now, Philomena, I think you're a bit fanciful, you know? But anyway, I was so pleased to prove them all wrong when Judy took on my part. And what a lovely, wonderful lady. And what a part she played as well.
Right. Oh, no. So it was a wonderful film. It was just terrific. And she's been nominated for Best Actress. And did you get to go to see any of the filming as it was occurring?
Oh, yes, we did. We saw...
We were on set several times, actually.
We were.
Probably the hardest scene was the scene where Anthony's leaving the convent. We were there. And the laundry scenes. We were there on the set that day.
Oh, God, yes, yeah.
And Mum actually said how well that they'd... told it, that they got it actually absolutely correct.
And Anthony was the name of the little boy.
Yes, Anthony Lee, yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, of course, he was adopted, or was he sold? Did they ever find that out or not?
He was adopted, but the parents, I know that a lot of American parents, 2,200 of these babies came to the United States, and they gave donations to the church. So we don't say sold, but there were big donations that went to the church. Yeah.
And did you have any contact with his American family after you found out?
No.
His adoptive parents had already died.
Oh, mm-hmm. Oh, I see.
When we found him.
And he got three brothers. They were his stepbrothers, I suppose. But
we have been in touch with the little girl who's now a grown woman that was adopted with him and his partner. So that was wonderful because they filled in all the middle years of what happened to him and gave Mum lots and lots of photographs and memorabilia of his life. So that was quite amazing.
Uh-huh. I know. It's such a wonderful story. And Steve Coogan, what do you think of him?
Oh, what a gentleman. He I never used to watch his funny programs and that, because I mean, I think that they're for young people, really, as I thought. But since he told me that he was going to he's taking the film from the book, I mean, he's been, and all this journey I've been on recently, I couldn't have found a better person. He's been such a support to me, a real, real support, and so kind and so... You know, I sometimes get stumped when I'm going to say, and he's there, he'll help me out all the time. Himself and Jeff Pope, both of them, well, I can't speak highly enough of them. They have been so supportive of me, and Jane as well, of course, yeah.
And you were really happy wonderful. With their interpretation? Of
well, of course
story.
I was. When I first saw it, I thought, oh, I'm not that silly Billy, really. But the main parts of the story, they got absolutely, they took everything we ever told them on board. The sad parts of it, the beginning of my life when he was born.
Yes.
Throughout my years when I looked after him for 3.5 years. And then the very sad parting when he went. The last scene, that's all perfectly true. You had to have some funny sides to it because it was such a sad story.
Yes.
And you have to have some laughter with the tears, really, I think. And they did a wonderful, both of them did a wonderful job.
Yes, because you didn't really go with Martin Sixsmith around America like in the movie. That was traditional.
No, that's dramatic license in the movie. We did all go to the United, we all went to Ireland together. Martin did come to the United States, but he came on his own. So that is dramatic license in the movie, but certainly all the scenes in the convent and all the early scenes relevant to Mum.
Well, listen, have a wonderful, wonderful time at the Oscars. They're telling me we have to go now.
Okay.
It's been a great pleasure and an honor to speak to you both. Thank you so much.
It's wonderful to talk to you. Thank you so
much. Thank you so much indeed.
All right.
Thank you.
And I always say, have a fabulous.
Yes, we will.
Oh, right. We hope so. We
thank
really
you.
Hope so. And thank you for your good
bye-bye.
Wishes. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.